Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 We give God praise. We give God praise. He's worthy. He's worthy. That all may go in. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, Lord. Let the people rejoice. Yes, Lord. Through Jesus the Son. And give him the glory. For the great things that the Lord have done. Yes, Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. And let the people rejoice. Everyone, let us come to the Father. Through Jesus the Son. And give God all the glory that he deserves. And give God all the glory that he deserves. And give him all the glory that he deserves. And give him all the glory that he deserves. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. And give him all the glory that he deserves. The glory, the glory, glory. And give him all the glory that he deserves. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Somebody lift your voice. Lift your voice. And give him the glory. For the great things that the Lord has done. And give him all the glory. The glory. The glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. My God. We give God the glory. For the great things he has done. The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy. My God, my God, Magadabada, lift up your voice. Yes, Lord. 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 And give God the glory for the great things he has done. We give God praise. We give God praise. We give God praise. Somebody lift your voice and give God praise. Give the Lord praise. We have covered a third of the month of November. We have covered almost a third. Today is the tenth. A third. We have covered a third of the month of November. Is it not amazing? Is it not awesome? Is God not so good? Is God not so faithful and loving? Is God not so merciful? Somebody lift your voice and thank God. For closer and closer, we are prevailing in the year 2021. Closer and closer, we are prevailing in the year 2021. Some enemies thought we could not make it. But here we are. Not by anything, but by the mercies and the grace of God. And also by the faithfulness of God. The Lord has brought us this far. So lift your voice and give God the glory. For the great things he has done. Lift up your voice and thank God. For the great things that the Lord has done. In the name of Jesus. It is the Lord who yielded his life and atonement for our sin. And he opened the life gate. Life gate. Yesterday I said that there are always gates which are waiting for our tomorrow. There is one gate called the gate of death, and another called the gate of life. And people of God, whilst you were about to wake up, the Lord came and took your soul and your spirit and walked you through the life gate. The life gate. The life gate. That is why you are alive. Whilst you are about to get to the day, some people go to work. I know of somebody who went to work, and then the guy said, I feel a bit tired, so I'm putting my head down on my table. People of God, that was the end of the guy. That was the end of the guy. He simply was tired at work, and the guy said, let me go and have some rest. That was the end. The guy did not wake up again. So whether you were asleep or you were at work, wherever you are or you were, it was a chance and opportunity for the devil to strike. But the Lord did not allow that. So lift up your voice and praise the Lord, and let the world hear his voice. Praise the Lord. Let the earth know that you know your God. Let the world know that you know your God. That you're being alive, your children being alive, it's not because of anything, but because of the mercies and the grace of God. Praise the Lord and give him the glory, greatest. Oh, and give him great things he has done. And give him the glory, great things he has done. And give him the glory, great things. And give him the glory, great things he has done. Oh, and give him all day long. All day long, I would love to worship the Lord. All day long, I want to give him the glory for the great things the Lord has done. And give him great things. When I remember great things he has done, great things he has done. When I remember Mary Wallace, I will give him the glory, great things he has done. When I look at the lives of Faith Aside, when I look at the life of Mary Wallace, when I look at the lives of Nancy, when I look at the lives of Julie, when I look at the lives of Beatrice, when I look at the lives of Pastor Emmy, when I look at the lives, my God, of Chiamaka, when I look at the lives of Hope Lady, then I will give him the glory for the protection he has given to them. For the protection he has given to them. And I will give him the glory, great things he has done. And I will give him the glory, great things he has done. And I say, I will give him the glory, the glory, great things. When I look at the woman of God, Akosua Pompe, when I look at Evangelist Claire, if I can see these wonderful sons and daughters, then I'll give him the glory. I will give God the glory for the great things he has done, for the protection, for the preservation, for the provision. He is worthy of that worship and praise. His worship of that worship and praise. He is worthy. The Lord is worthy. He is the immortal, invisible God. He is the most blessed of all. He is the most glorious of all. He is the Ancient of Days. He was in the beginning. He is and forever shall be. He was in the beginning. He is and forever shall be. The Lord was in the beginning. He is the Lord now and forever shall be the Lord. He was, he is, and forever shall be. He was, he is, and forever shall be. So he said, I am the I am that I am. I am the ego be God. I am the ego be God. When people ask, will your God come? You will tell them, yes, ego be. Will the Lord do it? You will say, yes, ego be. Will you make it? Yes, ego be. Will you live? Yes, we will live and we will not die. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I give you praise, oh God. I thank you for the lives of your people. I exhort you for your faithfulness. I exhort you for thy mercies. I exhort you, oh God, for thy grace, your grace that located us, oh God. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your protection. You are our defender, our life, our shield, our buckler, the lifter of our heart. Yes, Lord. We will adore you till you appear in your glory. And we shall sing like those in heaven. We shall sing like those in heaven. We lift our voice and our voices. We bless anticipation. Anticipation of the goodness of God. Anticipation of the faithfulness of God. Anticipation of the mercies of the Lord. Anticipation of the grace of God. Anticipation of the protection of God. Anticipation of the provision of God. Yes, Lord, we bless anticipation. We will cry aloud and give unto you, O God, the praise of our salvation, the praise of our salvation. For you are our salvation. You are our salvation. And we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Somebody lift your voice and thank God. Worship the King of Kings. Worship the Lord of Lords. Exalt his holy name. Exalt his holy name. Exalt his holy name. And we bless anticipation. We bless anticipation. Cry aloud and give to the Lord the praise of our salvation. The praise of our salvation. The praise of our salvation. Somebody cry aloud and give to God in worship the praise of anticipation of our salvation. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We give you praise. Malakada. Mazuli andabadabados. Brandos ilagavadesh. Prados andele ataba. Kavusi antelebosta. Mazuli kade labrandosa. Rabandere Kabarosa, Ivazus Aleta, Paros and Debelebosta, Ikabaros in the Resta, Lados Ante, Cabrande Tatusta, Rabos Ilagradosta, Macabos Ilagrade, Mazirianda Cabosta. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we worship you, Lord. We glorify you. We magnify you. In the name of Jesus, we magnify you, we glorify you. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. I came together, Lord, oh my Father, with the saints of God, upon this altar of power, upon this altar of glory, and upon the altar of grace. And we cry aloud, oh God, that let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts, Lord, let it be acceptable unto thee. We came to worship, we came to praise, we came to lift you up, for thou art worthy, oh God. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. I want to thank you on behalf of Wesley Cook. I want to thank you on behalf of Hope Lady, on behalf, oh God, of Nancy, on behalf of Faith Tashai, on behalf of Julie, on behalf of Beatrice, on behalf of Eulika. I pray, oh God, I came to offer you thanksgiving on behalf of the saints of God, in the name of Jesus, oh my God, on behalf of your people, I lift up worship, I lift up praise, worthy of your name, worthy of you, oh God, worthy of thy majesty, worthy of your rulership, worthy of your sovereignty. I honor you and I lift you up, oh God, for thou art worthy, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Our hearts and our voices we bless anticipation and cry aloud and give to God the praise of our salvation, and cry aloud, and we will give to God the praise of our salvation, and give to God and give to God the praise of our salvation. Church, listen. Most of the time in the night, the Lord will bring me an assignment concerning some of you that are attacked by the devil. And over the night, I will contend and I will pray as I am commanded by the Lord. And sometimes when I wake up in the morning, I ask myself, what is the news I am going to receive? But thank God for God, that when the Lord gives me an assignment to stand in the gap for some of you, I wake up in the morning, and during the day, I see a message from some of you, either greeting me or sending me a message of hope. And that makes me know that the Lord that woke me up in the night to fight for you is a faithful God. It's a faithful God. For as he commanded and I obeyed, people of God, I saw the manifestation of his faithfulness. Because I heard that you are alive and I got to know you are alive. And it gives me joy in my soul that the Lord that spoke to me and revealed to me what the devil wanted to do, and he commanded me to stand. The Lord did not disappoint when I prayed. Oh God, be thou glorified, be thou glorified in the name of Jesus. Somebody lift your voice and begin to pray. Lift your voice and pray. I was talking to one of my daughters yesterday, and my daughter was telling me a story, and it was regarding a conspiracy. So I had already prayed with my daughter some time, and I, the Lord, opened my eyes and I saw what was going on. And so there was somebody that I didn't know, but the Lord revealed the person to me. So I told my daughter yesterday, why do you think that the Lord mentioned the name of that person doing that evil to me? Why do you think the Lord did it? Because the Lord has given us the assignment to be the watchman over the people's life. The watchman. To be a watchman over the souls of the people. So I told my daughter that because we see and we watch, we are able to know the people. The people that are working against you guys and your children. May God be glorified. Lift your voice and pray for the forgiveness of sin. Pray for the forgiveness of sin. Pray for the forgiveness of sin. In the mighty name of Jesus. Pray for the forgiveness of sin. We have no other God but the Lord. We have no other God. But Jehovah our God. Somebody lift your voice. We have no other God. Lift your voice and pray. Ask for the forgiveness of sin. For we have no other God but the God of Israel. The Lord has done what no man has done. The Lord has done what no man has done. And the Lord is about to do what no man can do. No man. You have done what no man has done. And he was going to do what no man. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We have no other God but the God of Israel, the God of the heavens, the Alpha and the Omega, the Ancient of Days.
You have done
what no man
has done,
and you are about to do,
and you will
what no man can do.
I have no other God.
We have no other God but the God of the heavens, the Ancient of Days, the Alpha and the Omega. We give God praise. Pray for the forgiveness of sin, people of God. Pray for the forgiveness of sin.
We shall not in the dead.
In the name of Jesus.
We shall.
Thank you, Lord.
Not who they were.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. You are worthy. We thank you for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for the blood. 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 We give you all praise, all glory, all honor, all adoration. For you are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. We thank you for the blood. Somebody pray for the forgiveness of sin. I want you to thank God for the blood. For in thanking God for the blood will work for you. The blood will cleanse you. The blood will sanctify you. The blood will justify you. The blood will restore you. The blood will reconcile you with the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we thank God for the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood. I plead the blood for cleansing. I plead the blood for sanctification. I plead the blood for justification. I plead the blood for restoration. And I plead the blood. I plead the blood for cleansing and for washing, for purging, for sanctification, for justification, for restoration, for reconciliation. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I need no argument. Oh my God.
I need no argument.
Yes, Lord.
It is enough.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus died, and that he died.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus, we love you.
Yes, Lord.
Place.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I trust the
ever-living God. Pray for the anointing of the Holy Ghost as we enter into prayer. Pray for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. 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 Pray for the anointing. Pray for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Pray for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Pray for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of the of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody go with me to Luke chapter 11. Luke chapter 11. The devil is in trouble. Akwa Jimmy. Luke chapter 11. Luke chapter 11. Luke chapter 11. Luke chapter 11 and verse 20. Luke chapter 11 and verse 20. He said, but if I, with the finger of God, cast out devils, no doubt the kingdom of God is come upon you. If I cast out devils with the finger of God, then the kingdom of God will come. When we cast out devils by the finger of God, people of God all around us, in our spiritual warfare, there are devils and demons who are the soldiers of Satan fighting against you and I. Every problem has a demon behind it. Every problem in this life has a demon behind it. So here Jesus said, if I cast out the devils by the finger of God, which means that you can only cast out the devil by the finger of God. Sometimes we say we are casting out devils. When Jesus gave the disciples power in Matthew chapter 10, they were empowered to use the finger of God. We are going to pray today, church. I don't care the devils after your life. I don't care about the number of demons against your life. For I know that by the finger of God, you can cast out that devil. You can cast out that demon and that devil. Oh my God. Listen to me. In the Acts of the Apostle, chapter 19. There was said the sons of Sceva. The sons of Sceva were children of people who normally cast out devils from people. But on one particular day, they went to cast out devils and it did not work. Because they had nothing, they had not the possession of the finger of God. We are going to pray, people of God, that by the finger of God, tell the Lord that when I open my mouth and I pray, Lord, I possess your finger. I ask for your finger. I ask for your finger. I ask for thy finger. Lift your voice and pray. Church, I say behind every problem, there is a devil and there's a demon. Behind every problem in life, behind every sickness, there is a devil and there's a demon. But today the Lord said, I was able to cast out devils by the finger of the Father. So lift your voice and pray for the finger of God. For the finger of God. Pray for the finger. Pray for the finger of God. Listen. I love the scriptures. Because devils and demons, they are just some lightweight fighters. The Lord doesn't need to use all his hand or his arm. He needs the finger. We need the finger of God. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray, church. Lift your voice and pray. Demand the spirit and the finger of God. Pray for the finger of God. Pray that today, whenever you leave and whenever you lift up the prayer, you use the finger of God. You apply the finger of God. Somebody pray for the finger of God. Pray for the finger of God. Because we are about to cast out devils. We are about to cast out devils. Devils and demons. Devils and demons. We are about to cast devils and demons. And the Bible says, and Jesus gave them power. Somebody pray for the finger. Pray for the finger of God. Pray for the finger of God. Pray for the finger of God. Pray for the finger. Tell the Lord, I demand your finger today. I demand your finger today. My Father, my God, you are the man of war. I demand your finger today. Luke chapter 11, 20. If I cast out devils by the finger of God, then the kingdom of God will come. Then the kingdom of God will come. Somebody lift your voice and pray for the finger of God. For there are so many devils. There are so many devils. Devils and demons. The Bible said there was a man in the synagogue that was possessed by demon. How can somebody be in the synagogue of God and still be possessed by a demon? Somebody lift your voice. Lift your voice and pray. For the devils have no respect for area. They have no respect for territories. Accept the place and the territory of God. Accept the place and the territory of Jehovah. So lift your voice and pray for the finger of God. Pray for the finger of God. And your next prayer is that, tell the Lord that by your finger, I cast out every devil tormenting my life. I cast out every devil harassing my life. I cast out every devil intimidating my life. I cast out every devil frustrating my life. Lift your voice and pray. Pray with the finger of God. Use the finger of God and cast out the devils that are intimidating your life. They are intimidating your life. Lift your voice and pray that I cast out every devil out of my life, every devil causing intimidation. Sometimes the devil will frustrate you until you want to take your own life. The devil will intimidate you until you want to take your own life. I say, lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. The people that commit suicide, the devil frustrated them until they decided not to live anymore. I say, pray that the Lord will cast out every devil out of your life that is causing intimidation and frustration. Intimidation and frustration. Every devil. Every devil. I said pray. Somebody pray. Pray that by the finger of God. By the finger of God. Cast out every devil. Frustrating your employment. Frustrating your education. Frustrating your business. Frustrating your children. Frustrating your health. Frustrating your finances. Frustrating your marriage. Frustrating your work with God. I say, lift your voice and pray that by the finger of God, Kabosta. Pray. I am talking about Jesus. Luke chapter 11 verse 20. Jesus said, if I cast devils by the finger of God. Jesus gave us a master plan. He gave us a strategy that if we can cast out devils, not by our own ability, but by the finger of God, then the kingdom of God will come into our lives. Somebody lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Pray that every demon, every devil, you know the problem you are going through. Mention the name of the problem and cast out the devils behind that problem. Church, I say you know the problems. You know the problems you are going through. I say command the devil behind that problem to be cast out by the finger. Lift your voice. Lift your voice and pray. Until that devil is cast out, the kingdom will not come. Lift your voice and pray. Until that devil is cast out, the kingdom of God will not come. The kingdom of God will not come. Until that person is cast out, the kingdom of God will not come. I pray for the finger of God. I pray for the finger of God to cast out all devils behind every problem, all devils behind every frustration, all devils behind every intimidation, all devils behind every disappointment, all devils, all devils. All devils. All devils. All devils. All devils. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We give God praise. Verse 21. Luke chapter 11, 21. Luke chapter 11 and 21. Luke chapter 11, 21. He said, when a strong man armed keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace. When a strong man who is armed keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace. We are going to pray that the Lord will make you stronger and fully armed. The Lord will make you stronger and fully armed, so that the blessings the Lord has given to us, they shall be in peace. We are going to pray that God will strengthen us and fully arm us, fully armed, so that our blessings shall be in peace. Your marriage will be in peace. Your children shall be in peace. Your job will be in peace. Your prosperity, your mortgages, your inheritance, your properties, they shall be in peace. For the Bible said, when a strong man is armed, their goods, their blessing will be at peace. Church, there are so many times that the Lord blesses us, but because we are so weak, the devil comes and rob us. The devil comes and take it. We are lifting our voice and we are praying, the Father, make us stronger and fully armed. Make us so strong and fully armed. Lift your voice and pray. Pray for strength and pray for equipping. Pray that the Lord will equip you with full ammunition, that the Lord shall equip us fully armed, fully armed, so that the blessings of the Lord, the blessings of the Lord that came by the kingdom of God, it shall be at peace. Lift your voice and pray. Pray for strength. Pray that the Lord shall equip us fully armed, fully armed, so that the blessings of God in our life shall be protected and shall be at peace. For Luke chapter 11, 21, when a strong man armed protect their palace, their goods are in peace. Lift your voice and pray. Pray that God will strengthen you. Pray that God will strengthen you. And pray that the Lord shall equip us fully armed, fully armed, oh my God, in order to protect our blessing and our breakthrough. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Pray and tell the Lord, equip me fully armed. Make me stronger. Make me stronger. Make me stronger, oh God. Somebody lift your voice. Lift your voice and pray. Luke chapter 11, 21. He said, when a strong man is armed, and this man protects his palace, whatever is in the palace, people of God, they are at peace. Let me give you a revelation. First Chronicles chapter 4. There is a prayer of Jabez Akadabada. Church, it is not enough for you to pray for blessing. You got to pray for the strength of God and the equipping of God, fully armed. Fully armed. Let us go to the prayer of Jabez. First Chronicles chapter 4 and verse 10. And Jabez called unto the God of Israel, saying, O God, that you shall bless me and enlarge my coast. Bless me and enlarge my coast. And the next one, Jabez said, and that your hand will be with me. And that your hand will be with me. What is the meaning of this? The hand of God is the finger. The hand of God have the finger of God. The hand of God is the strength of God. Church, Jabez told the Lord, bless me. But above all, I need strength and power so that I can protect the blessing you give me. Church, lift your voice and pray. Jesus said, when a strong man is armed, the goods in your palace, they are untouchable. Lift your voice and pray. Tell the Lord to give you so much strength. Equip you with ammunition that the devil will not even dare come closer to your blessing. Share. I have come across situations that when the soldiers or the police are going to make an arrest, sometimes they have to show the criminal their pistol, and the criminal will be quiet. Sometimes the devil have to see your ammunition so that the devil will stay away. Sometimes people go and they want to go and get crash a ceremony. When they go and see the bouncer armed with muscles, they turn away. Church, lift your voice and pray. Tell the Lord to strengthen you and equip you with such ammunition that will turn the devil away from your blessing. That will turn devils away from your blessing. Lift up your voice and pray. Somebody, I say, lift up your voice and pray. Tell the Lord, arm me and equip me. Make me so stronger that by the near sight of my ammunition, the devil will run away. The devil will run away. Church, there are dynamics in prayers that the devil is afraid. And those dynamics are what I am teaching you. I am telling you, child of God, that Jabez prayed a prayer. And the prayer Jabez prayed, he asked for the hand of God. That your hand shall be with me. Jabez was not troubled with the blessing. For in blessing, God has promised to bless them. But when the Lord brings the blessing, how do we protect it? Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Don't tell me that when God gave it to you, it is the duty of God to watch over it. No, no. God only watches one to perform it. But after the performance, what next? After the performance, what next? It is up to you and I to be responsible enough to see and make sure that what the Lord has given to us, we are sustaining it. We are preserving it. 1 Timothy 1:18. And Paul said unto Timothy, my son, concerning the prophecies I have given to you, wage a serious warfare. You are the one to wage the warfare. Check and say, pray. Most of us have got a lot of blessings, but we were not strong enough. We were not armed enough to protect what God gave us. Are you not telling me that your child that had gone wayward, it was not the Lord that gave the child to you? The Lord gave you the child, but because you were not strong enough, because you were not armed enough, look at the state of your child now. we make errors. And that is why the Lord said, go to the people and let them correct the error. That there is always a devil behind every problem. And Luke chapter 11 verse 20, I, Jesus, I cast out the devils with the finger of God. And when I did it, the kingdom of God came. Church, when the devil is still operating, the kingdom will not come. I said, when the kingdom is operating, the kingdom will not come. When the devil is operating, let me tell you something. Genesis chapter 1. Genesis chapter 1. The Bible says, in the beginning, the Lord created the heavens and the earth. Now the Bible said in verse 2 that the word was without form and it was void. At that time, the devil was operating. So the Bible said, God said, I need to cast out the devil first. So the Bible said, God called for light. Light is the destroyer of darkness. So church, I want you to understand this. You cannot call for the kingdom unless you deal with the devils. You cannot call for the kingdom unless you cast out the devils. Because church, don't come and pray for a blessing. Otherwise, the devil will be a co-tenant to your blessing. The devils, they will become co-tenants to your blessing. And when the devil become a co-tenant to your blessing, you can imagine the frustration. You can imagine. I said, don't rush and pray for prayers. Don't rush and pray for blessing unless you cast out the devils. Cast out the devils. Cast out the devils. Don't go and say, I want to marry the man, and then later on, I will make the man become born again. No, cast out the devil in the man first. Cast out the devil in the woman first. No, I said the master plan and the blueprint is in Genesis chapter 1. And the Lord saw darkness, and darkness is an element of the devil. So the Bible said, God said, I cannot cohabit with the devil. I cannot make the devil a co-tenant. So the Bible said, and the Lord called first for light. Let there be light. And there was light. And I understand by John chapter 1 verse 5, that when the light came, the darkness could not stand. Let there be light. And the Lord saw that there was disorganization. Disorganization, confusion is of the devil. So verse number 3, Genesis 1:3. And the Lord said, let there be light. Let there be light. And there was light. Pray for the strength of God. Church, I say you have to cast out the devils. Cast out the devils before the kingdom of God will come. In the name of Jesus. But when a man stronger is armed, keepeth his palace. The palace is in order. The palace and the goose are at peace. Verse 22. That is our final prayer. My God, today the devil is in trouble. Because every day God brings revelations that is able to defeat the devil. Don't ever fight for blessing without clearing the house of demons and principalities. Don't ever make the devil your co-tenant. Don't. Unfortunately, many believers have made the devils our co-tenants. Co-tenants to our blessings. We should have to say, Bakum. And I am talking about those of us who allow the devil to use us, at the same time allow God to use us. I am talking about those of us who allow the devil to use us. You, the same person, whatever gossip that is in the church, you are the one that bring it. And you are the same person that also works so hard for God. Church, why are you a co-tenant with the devil? Why have you allowed your body to become a co-tenant to the devil? Church, unless you cast out that devil, you will not see the full glory of God in your life. Why are you using your body as an instrument of unrighteousness? Why are you allowing yourself as an agent of the devil in the house of God? Why? And then the woman who cried, why have you allowed yourself? Luke chapter 11:22. But one is stronger than he come and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor, which he trusted, and destroyed their blessing. One is stronger than he. We are going to pray that no power, no demon, no spirit will be able to overcome you. No. For the Bible said in 1 John 4 that we have rather overcome the world. So you are going to pray this prayer that no situation will overcome you. No condition of life will overcome you. No demon will overcome you. No principality, no boss, no friend, no pastor, no apostle, no false prophet can overcome you. I say pray. Pray your final prayer. My God. Yesterday I was talking to one of my daughters, and from the look of things, some powers have overcome the daughter. People of God, we are praying to stop it. We are praying to stop it. You see the world system. Society is overcoming the world of Christianity. The evil society is overcoming the world of Christianity. Church, if you are not conscious of this, then you are sleeping as a child of God. I said the evil practice of society is overcoming the church of God. That is why we can have archbishops who are fighting for gay marriage to be blessed. No, I am telling you, church, the society and the evil world is overcoming the church. That is why the head of a church can promote gay marriage blessing. Where we care for those guys because they have an issue. But for you as a man of God to promote a blessing of gay marriage, church, that person has already been overcome by the devil. No, I said the churches, whether it's because of the offering or what, I don't know. But church bishop, archbishops, there is an archbishop that was trying to condemn Ghana people, church. If you are a pastor at your country, if you are a pastor in Sodom and Gomorrah, shut up
and don't talk about what is going on in Cana. If you are a bishop in Sodom and Gomorrah, you got to shut up and don't talk about the people of Cana. Church, an archbishop, the people that are in Ghana's parliament, they are not archbishops, they are not pastors, but they have seen the majority of the people say no. Zimbabwe said no. Kenya said no. South Africa said no. No. And now they are using money. They are saying that if you don't allow gay, we will not, my God. Silver and gold belongs to God. There is no other place where God has endowed them. Let the people who are rejecting the gay, I say, if you are watching me, church, I feel for those who are in that situation. I love people who are gay and lesbians, but I don't condone their practice because it is anti-God. It is anti-God. It is anti-Christ. And I am not for the anti-Christ. I am not for anti-God. Anti-God. Church, they need our support, but they don't need inspiration from us in order to do what they are doing. I select your voice. A whole archbishop was warning a nation. My God. My God. My God. Are we in the slave times? No way. Israel has been delivered from Egypt. I say Israel has been delivered from Egypt. And we are no longer slaves of Pharaoh. We are servants of the Most High God. Pray and tell the Lord, let no power overcome us as a church, not no demon. Church, if we don't pray today, I am telling you that a time will come, they will tell a pastor that if you can't bless gay marriage, you have no license. Church, don't let us sit down. Don't let us sit down. I say, lift your voice and pray. Pray that no demon will overcome you. Pray that no power will overcome you. Pray that no principality will overcome you. Because the Bible said in Luke chapter 11, 22, that when they are able to overcome us, they will take what belongs to us. They will take our righteousness. They will take our moral rights. They will take our moral rights. Pray. Church, I said pray that no power, no principality, no occult power will be able to prevail and overcome you. Pray. 1 John 4:4. He said, ye are of God. We are of God. No matter how little we are, the Bible says we have overcome the world. For greater is he that is in us than they that is in the world. Where was that bishop? Where was Christ in that bishop? Who was warning Ghana people not to pass the law against gay akatada? Matabili katabada. Makula tina kusata. I said, just pray. For the Bible says we have overcome the world. For he that is in us is greater than he that is in the world. Church, this is the prayer the church have to pray. We don't have to pray chasing after come. You can have a miracle, but when the world and the government pass a law that can take your property, you can't say no. You can't say nothing. Hey, nowadays, you can sit at home and your daughter can come to you and tell you that I am a boy. You can't do them nothing because there is a law that back them. There is a law that support that child. I've got a daughter. Every time our daughter is talking, he said, very soon I'll get 18. Very soon I'll get 18. I sit down and I watch. You know why? Because the word and the laws has given that person the strength. And they are now planning how to become disobedient, how to become independent of their mother's advice. Because the law has given that power. And tell me, child of God, because the law has overpowered you, you have no power over your own child. You have no power. When your child gets 18, you are powerless, which means that you have been overcome by the laws of the land, and therefore you have no control over your own child. The God that gave you the child did not give it to the prime minister. The Lord gave the child to you, Nancy, gave to you, Olivia, gave to you, Hope Lady. I say, pray, for the Bible says, when they become stronger than us, they will overcome us. But we pray that Jesus will never leave you and I, for Christ in us, we will never be overcome. Lift your voice and pray. That bishop, that archbishop, yes, we're freeing him up. Christ have departed from that bishop. Christ have departed. Christ have departed. Christ have departed. Whenever Jesus see a demon in somebody, he casts it out. Whatever our brothers and sisters are going through are the works of demons. Gay fornal, any lesbian fornal, and a demon. It is a demon that is using them. And we got to pray and cast out the demons. Cast out the demons. Cast out the demons. We are not against gay. We are not against the lesbian people. We are against the practice. At the end of the day, everybody hates sickness. Most of us hate cancer. So when somebody gets cancer, you don't hate the person that have cancer. You only hate the sickness. You hate the sickness and the demon after the sickness. We love the people who are suffering from cancer, but we hate cancer. So the world have to understand us. We don't hate the people that are suffering from that condition, but we hate that sickness and that disease. So many years ago, they considered people like that as sick. So what changed? What changed? As we come to the end, you are praying that the Lord will give you the strength and the ammunition so that your children that the Lord has given to you, the devil will not come and take them. I say, pray for strength and ammunition so that the prosperity God has given to you, the devil will not come and steal it. Pray for the strength of God and the ammunition of God so that the marriage that the Lord has given to you, the devil will not come and take the marriage. May the Lord bless us. And may the Lord keep us. May his face shine upon every one of us. And may the Lord be gracious unto all of us. May his countenance come and dwell upon all of us. And may the Lord keep us in perfect peace. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, remain strong in the Lord. and in the power of his might. Remain strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Remain strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Our Jesus that lives in you is the reason why you are an overcomer. I say you are an overcomer. Don't allow Jesus to go out of you. I say Christ in you makes you an overcomer. Christ in you always makes you an overcomer. Christ in you always makes you an overcomer. Christ in you always makes you an overcomer. Don't allow God, don't allow Jesus to depart from you. Don't allow the Lord to depart from you. Don't allow Christ out of your life. I will see you again in the evening, and we will go into other dimensions of his presence and of his power. Until I see you, remain an overcomer. Remain strong. Remain fully armed. Fully armed. Whatever that belongs to you, no demon, when they see your pistol, when they see your ammunition, they dare not come closer. Keep yourself armed by God. Keep yourself strengthened by God. And your goods, your blessing, they shall be in peace. In Jesus' mighty name. Until I see you, stay an overcomer. Stay a champion. I salute you. I congratulate you. And I celebrate you. Go and perform wonders. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. We call it done. Amen. Shalom. Shalom. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.